Hello students, today I will explain a chapter for class 10 students. Today's topic is water resources. So first let's learn the sources of water resources. So about 97% of the earth's water supply is in the ocean, which is unfit for human consumption and other uses. Why? Due to its high salt content. Of the remaining 3%, 2.3% is locked in the polar ice caps. The balance, that is 0.7%, is available as fresh water, but 0.66% is groundwater, and the rest 0.03% is available to us as fresh water in river, lakes and streams. Now generally there are two main sources of water. What are these? One is surface water, another one is groundwater. So surface water. Now the water on land is the result of precipitation or seepage from underground, which forms streams and rivers. Number B is groundwater. Now the water from precipitation, that is from rain or snow, flows on the surface. The sum of the water evaporates and the rest flows into the soil. The water which gets collected under the surface of the land is known as groundwater, which remains in soil, subsoil or bedrock. Now next let's learn the need to conserve water. So what are the needs? Why we need to conserve our water resources? There are some reasons. So here I have mentioned some of it. First is the exploitation of underground water often results in the lowering of water table. So the loss of vegetation causes drought and reduction of rainfall of lowering of the water table. And irrigation utilizes more than 90% of the total fresh water. The increase in population results in scarcity. So these are the reasons why we need to conserve our water resource. So how we will conserve the water resource? So there are several methods. The most popular one is rainwater harvesting. So due to declining the availability of fresh water and increasing demand, we need to conserve water and manage our water resources. So the first practice, that is, or the method, that is rainwater harvesting, which is really common. Okay, so what is rainwater harvesting? It is the collecting and storing rainwater, which includes activities such as harvesting surface and groundwater, prevention of losses through evaporation and seepage, and all other hydrological studies and engineering interventions aimed at conservation and efficient utilization of water. So these are all the objectives of rainwater harvesting.